Good evening. Welcome to Talk Business. And a big hello as well to our viewers across the region receiving us through Sky Pacific. Tonight, tourism looks to elite clientele. The ADB dishes out its economic scorecard for the region, and Nut and Dollar upbeat despite recession. When it comes to the ultimate holiday experience, cost is not always an issue for some. While the country has seen its fair share of tourists, it's the upmarket clientele that remain largely untapped, but that could change sooner rather than later.
From jet boat rides to hot air balloon rides, Adrenalin Watersport South Pacific has introduced another first, a jet plane that is expected to attract big spenders. This was last week as Talk Business got a first-hand glimpse at the jet, which will be chartered by those who want to travel in style. The company already boasts a host of activities and is now crossing its fingers that a super yacht legislation could soon be promulgated.
It just gives another facet to Adrenalin's luxury market that we're trying to target. So the intention is to market the plane and tie it in with a sort of land and sea or air land and sea package, and bring in guests, you know, into Fiji and let them go out, you know, for 7 or 8 day charters in the group.
Adding that despite the global economic conditions, a time will come when people will start travelling again at all levels.
Previously there has been a big movement of, you know, corporate jets and private flights. So I think just having that option to at least go out and market to the world that Fiji has got luxury, you know, operations.
The company remains optimistic that the global crisis will correct itself and the demand for the chartered jet flights option will eventually take off. But far from resting on their laurels, the company has gone all out in its marketing campaigns and are hoping that the fruits of their labour will soon be seen.
The luxury jet option can travel from anywhere in the world, and I think there'll be a huge interest from regionally, both through Australia, New Zealand and through the North American and European markets. There's a high percentage of people that do travel this way, and there's 13 seats available on the jet. So if you look at it, two or three families, when you look at you know, the costs involved and I guess the comfort, it might be a once in a lifetime trip for a family, or it might be someone who has, you know, available to do that, you know, all the time. So hopefully when things come right, I think we should see this type of tourist in Fiji.
It's a concept that could easily be combined with land and sea packages, with the former being luxury resorts and the latter being yachts. And this is a move that will certainly work to the advantage for many in the tourism industry.
So the combination is quite creative, and again, just giving the traveller or, you know, the tourist a huge view of Fiji and travelling in style or in a different level, which is great.
He says that individual flight costs can't be identified at the moment as there would be some variations. And while this type of travel would be relatively expensive, Kurup says that there are people who like to travel this way, and then there are those who are willing to fork out some extra dollars just to have that once-in-a-lifetime trip.
You know, Fiji is an amazing destination and really hasn't touched its full capacity and potential of a broad spectrum from backpacker market to the luxury traveller, and I think, you know, unfortunately, during these tough times, you know, there is a light at the end of the tunnel, and I think, again, Fiji will pull through and get itself back on the map and get some frequency in its traveller.
Globally, the trend has been that travellers are becoming value conscious, but Adrenalin Fiji is hoping to change all this.
Adrenalin Fiji as a group, you know, we've got a vast variety of products. We're based in Denarau with a sort of water sports program to, you know, the luxury boats and also the retail and of the luxury boats. So yeah, we're trying our best to bring a different sort of traveller to Fiji who has possibly a little bit more to spend. So that's big picture stuff.
That being said, we asked Kurup what more could be expected of the company.
It's a blank canvas and we've got lots of paint.
Amelia Vunilamba, Futo Business.
The ripple effects of the global financial crisis continue to be felt in many countries. Just yesterday, the Asian Development Bank launched the inaugural Pacific Economic Monitor, which is a quarterly review of performances of Pacific economies. The monitor says that Fiji was able to halt its economic decline last year, through improved performances in key sectors like copper production, gold mining, mineral water production, electricity, building and construction. In tourism, the discount packages offered to visitors helped increase arrival numbers.
There are shifts, as was said in the presentation, you know, given the floods and perhaps some bad news about Fiji, tourists have changed their plans instead of going to Fiji, gone to Vanuatu or that. But also we're seeing, you know, there's been a big decline in the so-called long haul, you know, people coming from, you know, Europe or North America. And, you know, New Zealanders and Australians, while departures are down, you know, they may say, well, we're not going to go to Disneyland this year, but we might have a holiday in Fiji instead.
But while Fiji's tourist source markets are now turning elsewhere, Leonard adds that even in an economic downturn, many tourists were taking practical options in terms of holidays.
You know, I think there still is, even in a downturn, there is still, you know, a marketing opportunity. And, you know, charter flights or things that can reduce the cost of getting here, they can still make business sense.
Meanwhile, the ADB's monitor says the holiday is literally over for Pacific countries in terms of departures from Australia and New Zealand to the region. Previously, Australians and New Zealanders have made up a large chunk of tourist arrivals here, but that is now over. The ADB says arrivals from these countries are declining, and this is expected to result in a gradual decline in economic growth. As a direct result of that, economies like ours, which depend on tourism, can expect growth to contract further. The January floods have also had a hand in the decline in tourist arrivals, and coupled with political developments, have led to a drop in demand from the Australian economy, which is also slowing down. And we'll have more on the Pacific Economic Monitor later on in the show. It's a milestone achievement for the Financial Intelligence Unit following its endorsement as a member of the Egmont Group. Fiji is now the 116th member of the group, which is made up of other similar units from around the world. Our membership means that the Financial Intelligence Unit will now be privy to the Egmont Group's secure website for the purpose of information sharing and gathering intelligence. FIU Director Razim Bakhsh said, through its membership, the unit will be able to strengthen cooperation, networking and sharing of intelligence at the international level. This is all part of a quest to reduce serious criminal activities that include offences related to money laundering. In Talk Business Ahead, state services to go online.